Anyway, a big decision in the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals yesterday with the Peruta decision. We've been waiting for this case this decision to actually come out for quite some time. What was your initial reaction when you were reading this, Ken?
This is stunning. This is the broadest based Second Amendment federal appeals court ruling to ever be handed down. This is broader in its scope and more significant in its implications than either the Parker decision from the D.C. Circuit, which then went on to become Heller at the Supreme Court, or even the Moore decision from the Seventh Circuit regarding Chicago back in 2012. This is really an extraordinary victory for supporters of the Second Amendment.
All right. Now, let's talk about the differences between these cases, particularly the Parker case, which was out of the Seventh Circuit. That was a case that dealt with a complete and utter ban on the carrying of firearms. There was no concealed carry. There was no open carry. There was no carry. In this case, the law was a little bit different. When it was challenged, there was an open carry law in effect. But by the time it got to the Ninth Circuit, open carry had been banned by the state legislature in California. And the argument by the county there in San Diego was that there was actually a concealed carry law that was on the books, and people could carry concealed under these circumstances. And so nobody's rights were being violated. So this wasn't a quote-unquote clean case like the Seventh Circuit was, right?
That's correct, and that's why it becomes a broader ruling. In this case, California law empowers local law enforcement to set their own policies for who can receive a concealed carry permit, a CCW. And in this case, San Diego has a county ordinance saying that the local sheriff gets to decide, and the local sheriff's published policy is that they will consider on a case-by-case basis if you can provide some sort of special personal concern that you have, such as a restraining order or an abusive ex-spouse or threats of violence, something like that, but then goes on to explicitly say that a general concern for self-defense is not sufficient to get a concealed carry permit. And in a 2-1 decision, the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Ninth Circuit, in an opinion written by Dermot O'Scanlan, who is one of the greatest federal appeals courts, appeals judges in America, appointed by Ronald Reagan, the Ninth Circuit held that that restriction is unconstitutional, that you do have a general right to self-defense, which alone is sufficient cause that you should have the right to carry a firearm openly or concealed in public if you are a law-abiding and responsible adult.
All right. Ken, once again, it's fascinating to see the reaction of people who swear up and down they're not anti-gun, just in favor of common sense gun safety reform, because they're sounding awfully anti-gun today. They're not happy about this decision.
Oh, absolutely. They're having a fit about this because this really is a vindication of what the NRA has said for years, of what conservative legal scholars have been saying for so many years. I mean, if this becomes the law of the land, and I should add, it's, of course, as you know, I'm senior legal analyst for Breitbart News, and we'll have a story up shortly where I dissect the opinion and go through it. We already have another 5 stories already up on this issue. This case could, first of all, the Ninth Circuit it is by far the largest federal appeals courts out of the 12 courts. Mm-hmm. It has jurisdiction over a third of the United States, pretty much the whole western third. But beyond that, for various technical reasons that we don't have time to get into now, there is a decent chance that this case could end up before the U.S. Supreme Court in 2015 or 2016. And if so, this would be the new national baseline, the new law of the land from coast to coast. And if so, it would be a devastating defeat for gun control leftists, one that I'm not sure they would be able to recover from.
Are there other right-to-carry cases out there right now in the various levels of appeal? Is it possible the court would take something like the Drake case, which was decided, it was in the New Jersey case, I believe, the
possible,
the Third Circuit?
But I think very unlikely. I think Drake certainly raises out of New Jersey, raises some important issues, and some good friends of mine are involved with it. This case is a much better case, both in terms of the facts of the case and also, frankly, in terms of the quality of the legal teams that's representing them. Peruta is being represented by Paul Clement, who's probably the finest Supreme Court litigator alive and practicing today, versus some of these other cases that they're more local teams or teams that have a reputation for making some pretty outlandish and off-the-wall arguments that the Supreme Court has not shown much regard for in the past. So I think in terms of making sure that they're having the best possible legal team, making the most careful arguments with the most resources behind it, knowing that they're going to have all the evidence, all the law, all the history put before them fairly and fully to enable them to make the right decision, I think the Peruta case becomes a fantastic candidate. Though I would add, as an aside before that, that yet another case that Paul Clement has, representing the NRA itself, in NRA versus ATF, the Supreme Court, a week from today, will decide whether to take that case. That, too, would be a fantastic case. In fact, it would be a spectacular case. And we'll find out probably on Monday, February 24, whether the Supreme Court is taking that case for this fall.
And that is a case as well, Ken. I know that deals with 18 to 21. The issues are not the same as they are in the Peruta case, but that is another case in which the Supreme Court could get into the issues of the right to carry. The right to bear arms?
It is, and I think in terms of the development of the law, the Supreme Court wants to be very risk-averse here, and that's very wise, because the Second Amendment is used by 90 million Americans every day. It's been in this Constitution since 1791, but really the constitutional law on this only began with Heller in 2008. So in this very early stage, given its incredible implications, the Supreme Court is trying to be very, very selective on which cases it's going to take one careful step at a time. I actually think the ATF case is a textbook perfect case to have as the third Supreme Court Second Amendment case on the books after Heller and McDonald. And I think that ATF would then lay the foundation that would make Peruta the best possible fourth case. So if I could have my dream scenario for the development of constitutional law for the right to bear arms over the next 5 years, it would be for the Supreme Court to take ATF this year and then to take Peruta within 2 years after that.
All right. Well, listen, Ken, I appreciate you coming on the program and sharing your thoughts on the Peruta decision, and look forward to talking again very soon.
Thank you, Cam.
Absolutely. Ken Klukowski, the legal editor at